Welcome to this brief guide on how to use the Discover Pane in Microsoft Edge. The power of AI tools like ChatGPT is becoming more pervasive than ever before. So today I'm going to show you how Microsoft is building these tools directly into Microsoft Edge to make browsing the web easier than ever. Here I have Microsoft Edge open, and up in the top right-hand corner, what you'll notice is the Bing logo. This is the brand new Discover Pane. You don't need to click on it, you can simply hover your mouse over it and it will open up the Discover Pane automatically for you. You'll see three different options available to us there, the first of which is the chat functionality, then there's the compose functionality, and then the insights functionality. These are all powered by Bing and AI, and we'll cover them all today. The first option we're going to cover is the chat functionality, which is the newly revised Bing search. But first, we need to select the tone that we would like the AI to take when responding to us. Whether we choose balanced, which will provide a reasonable length of response with a little bit of creativity, or maybe we'd prefer brevity in the response and just get right to the information straight away for us. Or, like me, I would prefer the more creative one, which gives the AI a bit more freedom with its response. As you can see, the color changes based on the type of response that we've selected. Then we notice it asks us to ask it a question. So we can simply head down into the box that says, ask me anything. And I've got a question already in my clipboard, so I'll paste that in. And it says, I'm planning to visit Japan in late November. What are three of the must-see destinations? I can then submit my question, which you'll note I wrote in very natural language. It wasn't very much a standard web search style of language, but you can see that the AI is doing a regular search in the background and it's passing the information before it generates an answer for me. And here it's come up telling me that Japan is a wonderful country to visit in late November, as you can enjoy the beautiful autumn foliage, cultural festivals, and winter illuminations. It's then gone on to provide three must-see destinations based on web search results. And as we can see, it's provided me with the information, but it's also provided me with hyperlinks that I can use to check the information later on. So say, for instance, I wanted to know more about Lake Kawaguchi near Mount Fuji, or potentially Kyoto as its other suggestion here, I can then use the hyperlink to see the direct links where it's pulled this information from, and clicking on any of these links will open up that link in a new tab for me to continue my research. Now, as we can see, here is one of the websites that it's used to pull that information from, but this website contains a lot of extra information, such as potentially the regular temperature in Tokyo around this time of year. It's also quite a long website. So if I'd like to get a little bit of a breakdown of the information covered, I can use the third option, which is the Insights tab. Now the Insights tab is automatically recognizing the website that I have open up here in my tab at the moment, and it's pulled key phrases from the website itself, such as things to do in Japan, visiting and travel in Japan, and Japan in November. But as I scroll down, it's also pulled out some Q&A information from the site, such as that regular temperature in Tokyo. There's also options around when's the best time to see autumn leaves in Japan. It gives you a lot of that information that you would normally find in the website itself. There's also some related videos, such as the lovely videos from abroad in Japan. I highly recommend you check out his channel. It's amazing. And then underneath here, we have some additional related links that may be relevant based on your search, such as, for instance, the bottom one here, which is November 2023 events in Japan. And now that I'm done searching, I want to let everyone on social media know that I'm going to be in Japan. And so for that, I'm going to use the Compose tab. In here, I can simply type into the box my prompt, and the AI functionality inside Bing will help me write a LinkedIn post to let people know that I'll be traveling and working remotely in Japan for a few weeks. Then I need to head down to the next option, which is to select the tone and the format of my post that I would like. I can select options such as casual or funny, but because this is LinkedIn, I'm going to say professional. I'm also going to leave the option as a paragraph, but there are options for email, blog post, or a list of ideas if you'd like. Then we need to select the length that we would like our post to be. And once we've selected it, we hit generate draft, and it'll take a few moments for the AI to come up with a response based on the parameters we've given it. But in a few short moments, it's come up with a response right there for us, saying, I'm excited to share that I'll be traveling and working remotely in Japan for a few weeks in late November. It's a very professional designed response, but maybe I'd like one a little bit more carefree and a bit more funny. So I can simply head back up to the tone section and select the funny option, then click on generate draft again. Yet again, we just give it a few more moments while it generates a new response. but the new response we'll find is a much more casual, bit more funny attitude, such as, for instance, they're mentioning the land of sushi, anime, and ninjas. And it's also chosen to finalize the response with a lovely little winky emoji, just for a bit of fun. Now, you'll also notice there's a few icons underneath there that we can utilize, such as the option to quickly regenerate the draft using the same suggestions that we already had originally. We also have arrow keys that we can use to cycle back and forth between the different responses that we've generated. And then we have a button there that we can use to quickly and easily copy one of these responses into our clipboard to use wherever we need. And once we're done, we simply hit the X in the top corner to close it down. And that is how we use the brand new Discover Pane in Microsoft Edge. I hope you found this tip extremely useful and it makes your web browsing experience just that much better in the future. And I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel. And if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.